Hi viewers, this is Ravi Shankar. You are watching Ravi's Biology channel. In the last video, we have discussed some more important multiple choice questions in anatomy of flowering plants. So in this video, we are going to discuss some more important multiple choice questions in anatomy of flowering plants for medical examinations. Asked in the NEET and AIIMS and other medical examinations. Okay, first one. Companion cells are closely associated with A. Sieve elements, B. Vessel elements, C. Trichomes, D. Guard cells.
Here, A. Sieve elements is the right answer.
Okay, explanation. Each companion cell is usually closely associated with a sieve element. They remain connected with the sieve cells by plasma desmata. They help in loading of phloem sieve cells with sugars through active transport. Next one, second bit. The common bottle cork is a product of A. Dermatogen, B. Phellogen, C. Xylem, D. Vascular cambium. Here B. Phellogen is the right answer. Okay, next explanation. The cells of cork cambium or phellogen divide to produce an outer cork tissue, is also called as cork or phellum, and an inner secondary cortex. So secondary cortex is also called as phellodum. So here the common bottle cork produced from Quercus suber is a product of phellogen. Next one, third bit. The cork cambium, cork and secondary cortex are collectively called A. Phellodum, B. Phellogen, C. Periderm, D. Phellum. Here C. Periderm is the right answer. Okay, explanation. In hypodermis or outer cortical cells, a layer becomes meristematic, which is known as cork cambium or phellogen. So this phellogen also cuts off cells both on its outer side and inner side. The cells cut off an outer side or phellum or cork cells, and cell cuts off an inner side or phellodum or secondary cortex. So here, phellum, phellogen and phellodum collectively constitute periderm. Next one, fourth bit. The chief water conducting elements of xylem in gymnosperms are A. Vessels, B. Fibrous, C. Transfusion tissue, D. Tracheids. Here D. Tracheids is the right answer. Next explanation. The chief water conducting elements of xylem in gymnosperms are tracheids. These are elongated cells with tapering ends and are dead because of deposition of lignin. So these are the only water conducting xylem elements in both gymnosperms and pteridophytes. Generally, vessels are absent in gymnosperms with exceptions like neatum, welwitschia and ephedra. Next bit, fifth one. In barley stem, vascular bundles are A. Closed and scattered, B. Open and in a ring, C. Closed and radial, D. Open and scattered. Here, A, closed and scattered is the right answer. Okay, explanation. So, barley is a monocot plant. The vascular bundle of stem is conjoint, collateral, endoc, and closed. So, because cambium is absent. So, it is also scattered throughout the ground tissue. Next, another bit, sixth one. Passage cells are thin-walled cells found in A. Phloem elements that serve as entry points for substance for transport to other plant parts. B. Testa of seeds to enable emergence of a growing embryonic axis during seed germination. C. Central region of style through which the pollen tube grows towards the ovary. D. Endodermis of roots facilitating rapid transport of water from cortex to pericycle. Here D. Endodermis of roots facilitating rapid transport of water from cortex to pericycle is the right answer. Okay, next explanation. Endodermis is a single layered structure which separates cortex from steel. There are both thick-walled and thin-walled cells in the endodermis. The thin-walled cells are known as passage cells or transfusion cells, which are opposite the protoxylem groups. These cells help in rapid transport of water from cortex to pericycle. Next one, seventh bit. At maturity, which of the following is non-nucleated? A. Polysate cell. B. Cortical cell. C. CU cell. D. Companion cell. Here, C. CU cell is the right answer. Okay, explanation. In pteridophytes and gymnosperms, sieve tubes are not arranged in linear rows and hence called sieve cells. Sieve tube elements are the conducting elements of phloem. These are arranged end to end in linear rows with septa. Sieve plate. So I mean sieve plate. Between two sieve tube elements. In the sieve plate, there are present sieve pores. Sieve tube elements are living and have thin cellulosic walls in young cells, but they become thick-walled and are without nuclei at maturity. Next one, eighth bit. Which of the following plant cells will show totipotency? A. Sieve tubes. B. Xylem vessels. C. Meristem. D. Cork cells. Here, C. Meristem is the right answer. Next explanation. Meristems shows the totipotency because xylem vessels and cork cells are dead. So while sieve tube cells do not possess nuclei. Next one, ninth bit. Which exposed wood will decay faster? A. Sapwood. B. Softwood. C. Wood with a lot of fibrous. D. Heartwood. Here, A. Sapwood is the right answer. Next explanation. Sapwood will decay faster. Sapwood is less durable because it is susceptible to attack by pathogen and insects. Next, another important last bit, 10th one. A bicollateral vascular bundle is characterized by A. Phloem being sandwiched between xylem. B. Transverse splitting of vascular bundle. C. Longitudinal splitting of vascular bundle. D. Xylem being sandwiched between phloem. Here, xylem being sandwiched between phloem is the right answer. Next, explanation. A bicollateral vascular bundle is characterized by xylem being sandwiched between phloem. Here, there are two cambium rings. For example, cucurbita. So, these are the most important previous multiple choice questions for NEET, AIIMS, JIPMER and other medical examinations. So, thank you for watching all of you. So, please subscribe my channel. Thank you.